The pandemic produced a housing market that we haven't seen in over 10 years. With the combination of recession-induced low mortgage rates, remote work allowing buyers to move farther away from their workplace, a demographic wave of first-time millennial home buyers entering the market, and years of underbuilding leading to not enough homes available to meet demand, one would consider it a perfect storm. But how much longer will this last? There are already some signs that the housing boom is losing its steam, and after considering what experts are saying and what trends are already taking place, I think it's safe to say that the market definitely won't be as crazy in 2022 as it's been over the last 2 years. So stay tuned as I review some of the top predictions and trends to take place in the 2022 housing market. What's up, everyone? Brad Miller here, realtor at Berkshire Hathaway Home Services, servicing all South Jersey areas. Today, I come to you for a video going over my predictions for the 2022 housing market. And in coming up with this video, I read a ton of articles, watched a lot of videos going over, a lot of experts' top predictions for this year's housing market. And I could honestly go on for days, but I handpicked five of the most common predictions that I'm coming across and wanted to share them with you today. So jumping right into it, I'll be going through them point by point. And, you know, if you have any other predictions, you can definitely leave them in the comments. And I'd love to hear your thoughts on today's market. So jumping right into it, my first prediction is that foreclosures are going to rise pretty significantly. And the reason being is, you know, over the last 2 years, foreclosures pretty much have been turned off. You know, the government wasn't really allowing it. And, you know, you did have the mortgage forbearance going on. So, you know, a lot of homeowners were not obligated to pay their mortgage. And, you know, that, I believe, recently stopped taking place. So people now have to, you know, get back to paying their mortgage on a monthly basis. And with that and with the foreclosures opening up, I think we will see a pretty steady flow of foreclosures. You know, I do think a lot of people were financially irresponsible during the last 2 years. You know, people that could afford paying their mortgage decided not to just for the heck of it. And then they end up receiving thousands of dollars in stimulus checks from the government. They spend them in, you know, not too responsible ways. And now they're stuck with no money in the bank, and now their mortgage is due this month. So even though I do think a lot of people are in good positions and are still able to move forward and pay their mortgage, I do think a lot of people thought that this would go on forever and didn't really budget their money accordingly. And I think that will come back to bite them. And I wanted to end this point with a quote stating that there are hundreds of thousands of borrowers scheduled to exit forbearance in the next 2 months. And it's possible that we might see a higher percentage of those borrowers default on their loans. So, you know, the writing's on the wall, and, you know, we'll see what happens within these next couple of months as far as foreclosures go. But this point kind of perfectly leads into the next one, which is that inventory is to increase or improve. And, you know, point number one kind of solidifies that, you know, if more foreclosures are hitting the market, that would only mean that inventory would increase. But in addition to that, I definitely think things are easing up as far as the pandemic goes. And I think a lot of homeowners held back from putting their home on the market during the last 2 years because they were nervous about a ton of strangers coming into their house and, you know, not knowing what type of health condition they were in. So I do think a lot of homeowners kind of put their home sale on the back burner. But now that things are easing up, I'm hoping that, you know, a lot of homeowners feel more comfortable to put their homes on the market. So we'll hopefully see a healthy mix of foreclosures and standard kind of sales. And then in addition to that is new construction. So as you know, lumber prices and things of that nature were through the roof, you know, 6 to 12 months ago, and they now seem to be easing up a bit. So hopefully with that ease taking place, you know, a bunch of more new construction homes will also hit the market. So hopefully with the foreclosures, the standard types of sales and the new construction, hopefully that gives us a good mix of, you know, inventory, new inventory that we haven't seen for the last couple of years. Now, I do want to end this prediction in saying that this one is probably the most up in the air because there's just so many factors going into inventory increases. You know, we're unsure if people are more comfortable listing their homes at this time. But at the same point, or on the same coin, you know, I do think a lot of buyers are also getting more comfortable and entering the market, especially with these continued low interest rates. So, you know, this one, this prediction might be completely off and inventory might not rise that much because the demand is still there with a ton of buyers still being in the market and wanting to purchase properties. So, you know, I definitely do see a case for inventory increasing, but I can also see it on the flip side in that, you know, maybe it will remain the same, if not even get worse. So I'm kind of curious to see which direction that one goes into. Point number three, I definitely think that home prices will begin to slow. You know, just looking at some of the top leaders in the industry, you have CoreLogic, they're predicting only a 2% increase by September. However, you do have Freddie Mac predicting a 7% bump throughout 2022. And then you have Zillow predicting a 13.6% increase through October of 2022. So, you know, it's kind of all over the place there as well. But I definitely don't think, you know, some towns here in South Jersey, they experienced, you know, 20-25% year-over-year price increases. I definitely don't think we'll, you know, continue to see such high increases like that. But, you know, I definitely think they will gradually still increase, but just not as much as we usually have been seeing over the last couple of years. And, you know, in addition to that, a reason why a lot of these companies are predicting, you know, these upticks in prices are because of the first time millennial home buyers entering the market. So I wanted to share a quick quote with you. We're in the midst of a five-year period between 2019 and 2023 in which the five largest millennial birth years between 1989 and 1993 are hitting the all-important first-time home buying age of 30. According to their forecasts, there won't be enough homes to satisfy all of that demand. So that kind of goes back to, you know, point number two, and then, you know, bleeds into point number three, in that there's a ton of first-time home buyer millennials coming into the market, and they might be scooping up all the inventory, the additional inventory that's now going to be hitting the market. So it might just balance itself out at the end of the day. But because of this, it might also cause prices to increase, because if we're getting this whole new buyer pool of buyers entering into the market, that will continue to increase demand. And if supply remains pretty low, you know what that does for prices. So I'm excited to see, you know, where what direction that one goes in as well. Prediction number four is that mortgage rates will definitely increase. And I'm almost 100% certain about this. You know, you have the Fed talking about hiking up interest rates, and pretty much everyone you listen to, all the experts, they're pretty much all in agreement that interest rates will increase. And, you know, I read a lot through Redfin on this topic, and, you know, Redfin, they're expecting a 30-year fixed mortgage rates to rise slowly from around 3% to around 3.6% by the end of 2022, thanks to the pandemic subsiding and lingering inflation. That would be about $100 more per month in mortgage payments for the median home. So just, you know, a fraction of an increase in interest rate can greatly increase your monthly payment and overall payment of your 30-year loan. You know, to add on to that, let's say a borrower took on a $500,000 mortgage at a 3.1% mortgage rate. they'd see a $2,135 monthly payment. And this is not factoring in taxes or insurance. But if that rate were 3.6%, as projected by Redfin, that payment would increase to $2,273, or nearly an additional $50,000 over the course of a 30-year mortgage. So just to show you what a small fraction of an increase will do to you over a 30-year period, you know, that's 50 grand, which is not insignificant at all. So if you've been on the fence and, you know, because of the market being so crazy, you weren't sure if you wanted to enter into the market and purchase your first home or your next home, let this be a wake-up call in that, you know, yes, prices might still be a little inflated, but I think it's much better to, you know, maybe overpay slightly for a home than to get, you know, a half a percentage more on an interest rate, because over the 30-year period, I think that will negatively affect you much more than paying a few thousand dollars extra on the purchase price. So, you know, definitely keep your eye open for that, because I definitely think within the next few months, we will start seeing slight increases in the interest rates. And now moving on to my final point, which is that rents will see big increases. And, you know, I definitely think this is going to happen. I do think we're moving into becoming more of a renter's kind of society. So because of that, it only makes sense that rents will increase. And, you know, I wanted to finish with a couple of points to support that. So the end of mortgage forbearance will cause many homeowners to sell and rent instead. You know, if, you know, going back to point number one, if people haven't been paying their mortgage and haven't been too responsible with their money, they might have to foreclose on their home. And if they're foreclosed, they can't turn around and purchase a new one. They'll have to be forced to rent. So you have that. And then, you know, maybe if they're in the position to sell and not foreclose, they probably still won't want to purchase another property. So they might sell that property and just go into renting another one. So I think that scenario will cause a lot of new renters. In addition, as the pandemic subsides, more people will move back into cities where it's more common to rent. So, you know, as we saw the pandemic hit, a lot of people were nervous being in crowded areas, so they tend to leave the cities. But now as things are starting to ease up, these people are probably getting more comfortable to start congregating back into the cities. And, you know, there's only so many apartments available to buy, so it will be very likely that more and more people will rent in these areas. And then finally, the strong labor market will cause people to move to new cities. And, you know, if people are moving into new cities, they don't want to just buy a house in a random neighborhood that they're not familiar with. So if people are moving into new cities, they will most likely rent for a year or two just to get familiar with the area. And then once they're comfortable enough, they'll move forward and make a purchase. So because of all of those factors, you know, I think we will see a huge uptick in the amount of renters that are hitting the market, as if it already wasn't, you know, a lot of renters out there. But, you know, I definitely think that the rent prices will increase. And, you know, on a personal level, I'm already seeing that happen a lot here in South Jersey. So that about does it for this video. You know, those are my five main predictions for 2022. Of course, like I mentioned, if you have any other predictions that you've been, you know, throwing around, please feel free to leave them in the comments. You know, I'd love to get a full understanding of what people are thinking the market's going to do so that we can, you know, react accordingly. So I really appreciate you guys watching this video. I know it's a little longer than my typical videos, but of course, if you got any value out of this, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. And, you know, I definitely plan to ramp things up here in 2022, you know, definitely a video a week, if not more, and just trying to continue to provide you guys with a bunch of value. So of course, if you need any real estate help in the South Jersey area this year, all my contact information is below, so please feel free to leave me a comment, shoot me a text, or give me a call. And, you know, I really appreciate you guys for the continued support. And, you know, I'll definitely see you in the next video.